स्टार्टिंग इन 5 सेकेंड्स। ऑब्जर्व नेशनल सॉलिडेरिटी डे। इट वॉज एग्जैक्टली 2 ईयर्स एगो डैट आवर नॉर्दर्न बॉर्डर्स वर अटैक्ड। दिस वॉज सरप्राइज स्प्रंग ऑन अस क्वाइट सडनली, बट इन डैट आवर ऑफ पैरल वी सो अ अपसर्ज of patriotic feeling throughout the country. Differences of state, caste, creed or language, which had often seemed superficially to divide us, disappeared in a moment. It was a visible demonstration of the fundamental unity of our people, which has preserved the integrity of India through the ages. The farmer in the field, the worker in the factory, and indeed people from all walks of life came forward to make their own contribution in order to defend the country's freedom. On the borders, our soldiers fought with valor and with determination. So many of them made the supreme sacrifice and gave their lives so that the country might live. The whole nation remembers them with feelings of admiration and gratitude. We have, however, to remember that we should not be satisfied with what happened in the past. We have to realize that preservation of the freedom and territorial integrity of the motherland calls for incessant effort, vigilance, and alertness. The problems that we face today are serious indeed. The Chinese are trying to build up a mighty war machine and to create fear in minds of all. China has gone a step further and has recently exploded an atomic bomb. We are thus confronted with a nuclear menace in Asia, something new for this peace-loving continent. These are serious developments and we must take due notice of them. Even otherwise, in recent days, we have seen events of greater significance taking place in other parts of the world. Within the country, we are going through a period of difficulties. The production of the food is still inadequate. Harvesting of rice has begun and the new paddy and rice will be coming into the market. This will ease the situation in respect of rice for the present. The farmers are aware that the government is very particular that they should get reasonable and remunerative prices for their paddy. I hope they are aware of the fact that the producers' price have already been fixed and announced. It is therefore not unreasonable to expect that the kisan will come forward to sell their paddy or rice to the government at fixed prices also. The sowing of the rabi crops will soon start. Let us try to produce much more of wheat than we did in the year 1982. Which was a normal year. It is essential that the district administration should help in the supply of adequate seeds, manure and similar other facilities. Water for irrigation purposes is the most important item. The problem of water logging has greatly increased in recent years. Every effort should be made to see that areas liable to waterlogging are provided with necessary drains. Besides major irrigation projects, minor and medium schemes should also be taken in hand. Old tanks and ponds should be deepened. I am told that the construction of tube wells sometimes diverts attention from the existing irrigation works and even leads to avoidable duplication. It should always be borne in mind that new investment in tube wells should not make the older investment in structure, nor should it result in the neglect of the existing works. These are some of the reasons why the irrigated area in a number of states has not appreciably increased in spite of considerable investment. The district administration has to be much more alert and active to give all encouragement and assistance to the kisans with a view to increasing the production of their rabi crops. While wheat is important, there must be greater production of pulses also. The shortage of pulses has considerably added to our present difficulties. I know we all understand and fully realize that the solution of all our present day food difficulties lies in increased production. It is therefore essential that government officials in the districts and other at the state or central level, as also the farmers, should work hand in hand to produce a much better result. Let us show to the country that we can tackle our problem effectively by our own efforts and perseverance. The question of distribution has also assumed great importance. The cooperatives and the fair price shops have helped to a considerable extent in the present situation. With improved methods and with more effective supervision, they can do still better. Moreover, if consumer cooperatives can be organized by local initiative, they can be of much assistance in ensuring supplies to the consumers at steady price. I am sorry to say that grain dealers do not seem to have fully realized the gravity of the situation. This has led me to serious thinking, and the government must make some radical changes in the present system of distribution. Stop.